thanks to the Millennium Stage crew here and the Performing Arts for Everyone program here at the Kennedy Center for inviting us back. It's such an honor to be here. Before we start the recital tonight, I just wanted to share a few words about Levine music and about some of the students you're going to see here tonight. So Levine Music is one of the country's largest nonprofit community music schools. And what that means is that we accept anyone of any age, ability, or level of financial means to come and enjoy music with us by taking private lessons or group classes or ensembles. We have 5 campuses throughout the Washington, D.C. area, 3,000 students spread across those 5 campuses. And our students range in all ages, from in our early childhood program, our youngest participants are 4 months of age, 4 months, and our most seasoned adult student at this point, we believe, is approaching his 101st birthday in our piano department. So everyone here would find a home at Levine. The students you'll see on stage tonight are from our honors program. Every year, we audition and interview students. Out of those 3,000 students across the school, we hand select through an audition and interview process 25 students to represent Levine, 25 students under the age of 18, and they represent Levine as our musical ambassadors. They're accepted into the program, and while they're in the program, they participate in a wide range of activities throughout the year, from field trips and workshops, lectures, theory classes, and we also place them into chamber ensembles with each other, and they rehearse throughout the year, and they're going to be performing. A lot of the performers tonight are in those chamber ensembles. A quick word about chamber ensembles. When you see two or more performers, musicians performing together on stage, you're seeing an equal partnership. You're seeing great teamwork at play. If you see, say, a flutist and a pianist performing on stage, it's not that the flutist is necessarily the soloist and the pianist is there just in a supporting role. They're equal partners in creating music together. And it's this great teamwork that brings together good chamber ensembles. So you'll see a lot of that teamwork and partnership on stage tonight. So, without further ado, thank you all again for joining us here tonight, and please join me in welcoming to the stage our first performers, Noah Pan-Steer on violin and Andrew Wu on piano.
Thank you. Good evening. The following piece is an original composition of mine. My name is Camilo Gonzalez Sol. What you'll hear is a setting of Christina Rossetti's Time Be Run for mezzo-soprano and piano. This poem really fascinated me because it explored kind of unconventional ideas about what it means to exist. Rossetti explores the idea that humanity might be meaningless. She is very much toying with existentialist ideas and observing that throughout time, human nature seems to stay the same. And looking at the implications of that, is humanity meaningful from that? And so what you'll hear in the music is a little bit different from other pieces. I really tried to bring out a very cool passivity that I found in the tone of her poem, which really fascinated me. You'll hear a lot of cyclical motives, a lot of patterns in the music that keep going on to evoke the sense of time or clockwork. And at the end of the piece, you'll find that it doesn't end on a definitive or resolved point. It ends with uncertainty, exploring the uncertainty that we all have for our own, for the meaning of our existence. It's a little bit different, but I really would like to invite you to get inside the poet's head to see what those ideas do for you. I don't know if I totally agree with Christina Rossetti, but I think it's really interesting to see her ideas, and I hope that through this music, we might transport you somewhere else. I really hope you enjoy this performance of Time Be Run. Thank you very much.
Still the whole Mm-hmm.